There's a famous story about your WrestleMania return in California that Triple H, Hunter Hearst Helmsley, came to you and he threw out all these suggestions and you basically said, the match is not about you, it's about me.
Well, I didn't hear any suggestions, but what happened was, and I didn't know Hunter. You know, all I knew was I was coming back as Ultimate Warrior, and the guys that were on top, that Vince was using on top, were the B-team players when Ultimate Warrior was there.
Right.
And I wasn't going to come in. Look, there could have been a lot of adjustments that could have been made over time, and there were even for the 4 months that I was there with Ultimate Warrior. But to come back after 3 years, I was going to come back and make an impression. And it wasn't about that I had a malicious plan to disparage anything that Hunter Hearst Helmsley had done in his career up to that point, or to say he's not any kind of talent or anything like that. It was just come back. It wasn't harmful. You know, people talk about things are harmful, you know, doing the job and this and that. They are to some degree in the beginning, but they're not as much today. You can fix things like that. And I told him what I wanted to do, that I was going to come and make my entrance. You give me your finish. I'm going to kick out of it, and then I'm going to give you a press slam. We're going to go home. And he said, okay. And then he went and got Jerry Briscoe. Came in the locker room. We went in the shower, and he proceeded to have Jerry Briscoe try to tell me that he had all these ideas. And I listened to Jerry for about 5 seconds, and I looked right at Hunter. And I said, if you ever have anything that you need to discuss with me, you need to come to discuss it with me face-to-face, man-to-man. We're done. And that was it.
Okay. Did he ever apologize?
And he did. No, and he didn't need to. You know, he didn't need to, per se, to apologize to me. I can understand how he would have took it. But I'm sure today, in some ways, I could probably take a little credit for what he's done in his career. Right. Because I know if somebody had done that to me, what I would have done, I would have said to myself, we'll see. We'll see.
Right.
And look what he's done in the business.
He's, you know, one of the most powerful people in the company.
So it's kind of funny. I've thought that over the years. I thought, you know what? I didn't mean to do that. But he did. And I can understand how he would have took it that way. But if he wants to tell the story a different way, then he's the puny little bastard on the inside that he was back then.
Right.
You know, he's not the guy that's built a really credible career in the business and seems to love the business. He's still the puny little shithead that he was in 1996, and I'd tell him to his face again.
Right. How had the company changed from the last time you were there?
It hadn't really.
No.
I mean, there was the clique going on between Nash and Hall and those guys are scumbags.
Right.
I mean, they're just, you know, the kind of ribs and stuff that they would play and tearing people's stuff up, and they always got ulterior motives to destroy people instead of concentrating on what they have to offer and what they can do. They got to play both sides and try to, you know, damage other people's abilities from the backside.